In the spotlight from the age of 16, he became an AFL champion.
It was probably one of the most exciting phases of my personal life. And I went from sitting down watching them on TV to literally 18 months later playing against them. So it was intimidating, scary, but at the same time it was really exciting.
What was it like going from a star footballer to hands-on work with your foundation?
It's a planning that you have to do after that phase is finished, and fortunately I was able to set up a foundation and provide all the community work that was one of my biggest aspirations as a young person. So I was really keen on taking that on, and I suppose having that ready for me really made it easy for me to retire and leave that big phase of my life as well.
An outspoken champion for Indigenous rights.
Unfortunately, my grandmother passed away, not even recognised as an Australian citizen. It's frustrating, and you think about 1968, where we, the first time we can actually cast a vote.
Well, this year you ran for a seat in the Senate in the federal election with the National Party. Why politics?
When you run a not-for-profit organisation and you completely fight every day to justify the importance of a program for Aboriginal women, for Aboriginal people, and you keep getting knocked back every second time, it becomes frustrating.
Determined to make change.
I've got this thing in my head where I just need to build an empire for our people.
And he has a message for the Prime Minister.
Put me on the advisory committee with Warren Mundine, and I'll make sure they're all straight and narrow.
Meet the next king of Arnhem Land, businessman David Wirrpanda, striving to rid the disparity between Indigenous and non-Indigenous Australians.